Radiological screening tests play an important role in detecting the disease conditions at an early stage. Today we are in conversation with Dr. Arpita Thamba, radiologist at Surana Sethia Medical Center, Mumbai. Welcome, doctor.
Hi.
We are glad to have you here today.
Thank you. Same to you.
So, doctor, if you can just start by telling us, what are various preventive radiological techniques and how it helps in detecting the diseases at an early stage?
Okay, so let us come to the techniques first. There are various techniques. One is X-ray, second is sonography, and third is CT tests. In X-rays, we check out whether the lung has got any abnormality, any lesions. In ultrasound, we check the status of all our organs in the body, like liver, spleen, gallbladder, kidneys. We check out if there are stones there, if there is a mass lesion, you know, in layman term we can say gant or something like that. And in CT scan, we check out the status of brain and our coronary vessels, you know, the vessels which supply the muscles of our heart, the most important vessels in our body.
And how do you think preventive screening tests help in early diagnosis?
See, actually these are small baby steps for a better future. You know, suppose you detect a small block in your coronary vessel and maybe you can just go for an angioplasty instead of a bypass operation later on, you know. You detect small gallstones and maybe, you know, you can just go for a simple lap cholecystectomy rather than a complicated open cholecystectomy, you know. So there's small things which help you to build you a better quality of life, a better future.
बहुत सारे बार हमने सभी लोग ने देखा है मूवीज में और टीवी में there's a donut shaped kind of a machine and patients are going inside that. That's what a CT machine is.
Yeah, true.
But can you tell our viewers in a layman's terminology what a CT based test is?
It's actually very simple and very non-invasive. You know, the patient in just the previous day, the patient has to be fasting. Say overnight fasting is enough. The patient has to go for a basic blood checkup like a serum creatinine to know the renal status of the patient. And thirdly, if the patient is pregnant or something, CT scans should be completely prohibited because radiation is an imminent danger to them. The next day, the patient comes to the hospital, gets an IV line set up in his vein and lies down in the table. That's all the patient has to do. And maybe hold breath for a couple of seconds, that is to be precise 13 to 15 seconds. So then we inject an IV bolus, about 80 ml of contrast. The dye, it goes into the veins and it opacifies all the vessels. Jitne bhi blood vessels hain body mein, wo sab aise chamak ke aate hain. You can say that, you know, it kind of magnifies and enhances those vessels. And we get to know whether there is block in some way, whether, you know, some part of the brain or any part of the body is lacking in blood supply. Those small things are, you know, very important for a better future, for a better health of the patient.
Right. What all are the disease conditions or abnormalities a CT angiogram or CT brain or CT neck can detect?
Okay, CT brain can detect lot of things, you know, something like a brain, a blood supply is not reaching a small part of the brain. It can be nicely seen in a CT brain, you know, contrast enhanced CT brain. The CT coronary angio, I must say, is like a revolutionary thing which has come into our hospitals nowadays. The blood vessels, you know, we have namely two blood vessels, the right coronary artery and the left coronary artery, which supply the muscles of the heart. Whether the supply is adequate, whether there is any blockage in the vessels, these things we nicely see in the CT coronary angio. The contrast of the vessel, they nicely delineate the vessels and we see if there is any, you know, 50% block, 70% block or no block at all, which is very good, you know, anyways. So those things we nicely see in a CT coronary angio.
Right. Are there any limitations or contraindications to a CT test?
Very few contraindications. You have a previous allergy to the iodinated contrast we give. Any renal impairment we get to know by, you know, doing a serum creatinine the day before. Pregnant patients cannot go for any drug allergy. And one thing, you know, sometimes we give a small drug to decrease your heartbeat. The heartbeat should be somewhere between 60 heartbeats to 80 heartbeats. If it is between that, no problems. But if it is not, you know, sometimes due to anxiety or something, your heartbeat increases. So we give a small drug called a beta blocker to decrease the heartbeat.
Right, exactly. So doctor, what is the detection rate of diseases whenever someone comes across for a preventive radiological test?
Okay, so in this, let's think about the CT scan. The CT scan has come along lot of generations. The first generation was one slice, then it came down to 4 slice, 16 slice. Now we have this 64 slice awesome CT scan. In 4 slice, the detection rate was something like 20 to 30%.
Okay.
In 16 slice, it was like 50 to 60%, which is quite low by standards of cardiac radiology. In 64 slice, the detection rate is something like 90%, which is phenomenal, I must say.
I'm sure all this informative knowledge that you have shared with us is going to be valuable for our viewers. Thanks a lot, doctor, for joining us.
Let me give you just go home message. Please go for all your preventive checkups, all your preventive screening measures to ensure a very nice and prosperous, healthy future life. Thank you.